Hello guys, Aris from HWbusters. Today we have the AeroCool Aero Bronze 650 watts. I have my notes because it's quite a lot of the things I want to talk about. Efficiency, obviously 80 plus bronze, and cybernetics ETA-A minus, and noise lambda A plus, meaning 15 to 20 decibels overall noise output.
Wait, isn't this very good?
Yeah, it's very, very good.
So why isn't there a bad here to say
that? I know, ask AeroCool. I don't know, ask AeroCool about that. Okay, it's not a modular PSU. All cables are fixed. Basically, it's an affordable PSU. It's highly affordable, but we will come to that in a while. Dimensions, compact, only 140 millimeters depth. Price, that's where it's the interesting part. 55 pounds in the UK market and 60 euros in Europe. This is highly affordable. It doesn't actually compete with the Corsair CX 650. It's more expensive, about 20 euros more expensive, since it uses a pretty high-end platform for this category. Warranty, 2 years, only 2 years. This should be increased to 3 years at least, in my opinion at least. Power specifications, we have a single 12 volt rail which can deliver the unit's full output alone. This means that this PSU uses DC-DC converters for the minor rails, so the platform is quite modern. Connectors, adequate number of connectors, 1 EPS, 2 PCI Express, 6 SATA and 4-pin Molex. No Berk connectors, Aerie's favorite, I don't know why, ask her. And yes, fixed cables, so larger number of connectors wouldn't make any sense. And although I would like to see a second EPS. Cable length, long enough cables and 150 mm distance between all peripheral connectors, which it's very, very good. No in cable cap. And build quality, modern enough platform, DC-DC converters on the secondary side, as far as I remember, double forward on the primary side. Build quality is mediocre. The soldering quality is not that good, but it will make the job just fine. You won't have any problems, I guess. What troubles me is the Asia X electrolytic capacitors that it uses. I would like to see a bit better caps, at least elite caps, and I don't believe that the cost will be significantly increased using elite caps, or at least good typo caps. The bulk caps belong to Nissicon, two of them, so they are very good. Usually manufacturers use good bulk caps to avoid any problems. The fan, 120 millimeters. Rifle bearing fan, decent quality for this price range. Let's go now to the protection features, which are the most important. We have properly set overcurrent protection and overpower protection, which is nice, obviously. Over temperature protection is present and working good. The only downside here is that there is no move metal oxide varistor in the transient filter, which means that you are not protected against surges coming from the mains network. Come on guys, move it. How much it costs? 50 cents, I don't know, just install one. Overall efficiency, good efficiency levels. It loses only to the Corsair CX650, which is more expensive, as I already mentioned, and uses a much more advanced platform. LLC resonant converters, half bridge, etc. etc. Overall noise output, this was a very nice surprise by AeroCool. Very, very low noise output. It actually makes me wonder whether it will survive under tough environments with such a relaxed fan profile. But I tested it under increased ambient temperatures, and the fan kicked in hard. So I guess you won't have any problem, at least for the 2 year warranty period. Overall performance, high overall performance. Again, only the CX650 performs better, but okay, it's more expensive. Bottom line, the AeroCool Aero Bronze 650 performs well. It is very quiet. Actually, one of the quietest 650 watt mainstream PSUs that I have tested so far. And on top of that, it is affordable. Not everything is perfect though. As usually is the case in every product out there, especially PSUs that I test. At the Eternals, the Asia X caps are not among my favorites, and they should be replaced with elite or quality cheapo ones to keep the cost in control. Finally, it will have the edge over the competition if it had a second ETA-S connector. It will provide it with compatibility with high-end mainboards. Now, if you ask me who will ever buy such an affordable PSU to use it along with a high-end mainboard, okay, that beats me, I don't know. Pros, deliver it full power at over 40 degrees ambient, silent operation, high enough performance for these categories standards, always, good efficiency levels, highly efficient under light loads, 40 to 100 watts, decent 5 VSB efficiency, ripple suppression is good on all rails, but only on 3.3 volt I would like to see a bit better ripple suppression, satisfactory load regulation on all major rails, extremely tight load regulation at 5 VSB, amazing performance there, most protection features are correctly set, accurate power OK signal, within 100 milliseconds power on time, which provides it with compatibility with the majority of mainboards, adequate number of peripheral connectors with 150 mm distance between them, cons, average build and soldering quality, you get what you pay for in this case. The Asia X capacitors should be replaced with good elite or cheaper ones. There is no move in the transient filter, that's a major con in my book. A higher resistance NTC thermistor should be used to lower in-ras currents, and a bypass delay for the NTC thermistor will greatly enhance in-ras current suppression, but it will also add up to the total cost. Lower than 70 milliseconds hold-up time, actually much lower, and the power OK signal's hold-up time is low too. This is the case in most affordable PSUs in this price range. And it's because of the low capacity bulk caps, which cost a lot. Not so good transient response, and especially at 3.3 volt. Vampire power consumption could be lower, and only one ETA-S connector. Let's do some real testing, shall we, on this unit. Okay, here I have a fast auto, programmable active load, and PassMark inline PSU tester, which will help me show you better the results. Starting, let's power on the PSU. Okay, all voltages are in control. And let's apply some loads to it. Actually, there's already load applied. It's 524 watts. Let's increase it a bit. A minute. Okay, I'm increasing the load on the 12 volt rails. I want to go full load, right? You agree?
What can go wrong?
I don't know. No, this unit has been tested and it's at low ambient right now, so it won't have a problem. But let's increase the load and see what we have here. 600, 20, 30, 40, 650 watts I want. I will increase the load on the minor rails. 650 watts. Okay. Everything is in line, voltages in control. The same goes for ripple. I see a bit increased ripple at 5 volt, but I guess it's the pass mark. In my scope, ripple was lower actually. 12 volt ripple goes up to 57, so it's quite good. At 3.3, There was a spike there, but it's not anymore. Okay, and I hugely overload the 3.3 rail. Okay, let's lower a bit the ripple, the load at 3.3, because it's very, very high. Okay, we have load 645 watts, all voltages in control. The same goes for ripple on in all rails. Timings are quite good, as you can see. Tenon slopes I see pass everywhere, so we're all good. A spike at 3.3 volt I see, but I have a very high amperage on this rail, almost 18 amperes. You will never stress the 3.3 volt rail so high, and also 18 amperes on the 5 volt rail. This will be probably stressed because of the RGB lighting. The LED RGB strips heavily use the 5 volt rail. Everything is good, as you can see here. Okay, power on again at a lower load, 578 watts. Because my loader shuts down, it gets hot. I need a new one ASAP. Again, ripple in control, voltages in control. We'll perform a short circuit protection test on the fast auto. We will short circuit, I will short circuit the rails with earth. Okay, those are the rails, 3.3, 5 volt, the two 12 volt rails, minus 12, okay, minus 11 actually, and the 5 is B. Let's start with 3.3. Okay, the PSU shuts down as it should. Start it again, 5 volt. Okay, shuts down again as it should. Let's do the 12 volt now. Yeah, no problem either. And the other 12 volt rail. Okay, let's do 5 VSB now. Yep, and it starts again. The PSU starts, actually turns on. This is not a problem according to the ATX spec. Okay. Short circuit 5 VSB again, standby mode, only 5 VSB active. Short circuit the 5 VSB rail, yeah, and it's again, it latches again on. Turn on, turn off, 5 VSB, and again. One last time on the 12 volt rails. Shuts down. No problems here. As I already mentioned, we short circuit the rails with earth. Now I'm going to do something more tricky. I will short circuit the rails between them. Yeah, this is nasty, but I will do it anyway. Okay guys, now the real deal, we will short circuit the rails between them. 12 volt rail first, just a moment, also measure voltage. Okay, 12 volt rails here, yep, and 5 volt is right beside.
And why are we doing this?
To see if you short circuit two rails between them, if the PSU will handle this extreme case scenario. Okay, both here and here. Tiny, tiny spark. Okay, the PSU shuts down.
Was it good or bad?
Good.
Because it shut down. Put it again and leave it there.
Please.
Okay, shuts down, the PSU shuts down. You can see the fan stop working. Okay, now let's see if it will start with a short circuit.
Does it?
No. It just gives a pulse as it's supposed to do and doesn't start. You see, it immediately shuts down because it detects the short circuit. Okay, let's move now. 12 volt and 3.3, it's here.
Yeah, I saw the sparkle.
Yeah, it shuts down. Let's see if it will turn on. Nope. It cannot turn on because we have the short circuit. Okay, remove it. Yep, it starts. Let's do now 3.3 and 5 volt.
Okay. You are torturing the machine, right?
Yeah, yeah. But it should be fine. Yeah, shut it down. No sparks. And it cannot start. Okay, remove the short circuit. Five is big with ground, while the PSU is turned on. It stops. Okay. Once I move the short circuit, it starts again, as it should, because it was already on. Let's do now the minus 12 volt rail. Minus 12 with ground. Stopped. Minus 12 volt with 5 volt. It stopped. Minus 12 volt with 12 volts. Wow.
Okay.
Yeah, that was nice, huh? It stopped. Minus 12 with 3.3 volts. Ah, only small spark. It stopped. And minus 12 volt with 5 VSB, my favorite.
Combination, right?
Yeah.
There was a sparkle immediately.
Yeah, and it stopped. Now it stops. connector. Okay, that was all. See you in the next video. Bye bye.